Google and YouTube are tightening the screws on the ad blocker market, once again, making us ask the question, how to block ads these days? So whether you're on Google Chrome or Firefox, ad block is necessary. But what is the best ad blocker you can get? All right, the first ad block for Mozilla Firefox that I want to mention is the NordVPN Threat Protection. It doesn't just deal with consequences by blocking ads once they appear, it also proactively denies websites' requests to display those ads, notifications, or pop-ups. So Threat Protection prevents any tracker access to your connection as well. So most importantly, even if you end up downloading a file containing malware, yeah, it'll detect that and then get rid of the file for you. One thing to keep in mind is that you can use Threat Protection as a Firefox extension or as an app on your computer. So I prefer the app since it allows me to enable this ad blocking feature permanently, so I can always be protected against adverts. But in the browser extension, Threat Protection Lite only works if you're connected to the VPN server, kind of forcing you to use the VPN for the ad blocker benefits. But since that only adds additional security and allows me to access lots of geo-blocked content, it's hard to see that as anything other than an upside. Oh, also in my tests with canyoublockit.com, Threat Protection dealt with all the ads successfully, even blocking the ads before videos. Very useful for a certain website, if you know what I'm saying. Overall, though, NordVPN Threat Protection is really an affordable ad blocker with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you can test it risk-free. And oh, remember the most important part, if you check the link in the description, yeah, you can get the NordVPN Threat Protection with an exclusive discount. So go check that out. But if you're looking for the ultimate value, I'd say Surfshark's CleanWeb is your choice. It's another ad blocker for Firefox that comes paired with a VPN, but it's on a different level from NordVPN. First of all, Surfshark is more affordable and it can be used on any number of devices at the same time. And you get a 30-day money back guarantee as well. So that's a nice way to test Surfshark out. And in terms of dealing with ads, CleanWeb takes the same approach as Threat Protection. It's both reactive and proactive, though it doesn't take care of malware as Threat Protection does. But CleanWeb on Firefox has a different cherry on top. Ever since it was updated to CleanWeb 2.0, it's added malware and data breach monitors. And these features show whether the website that you're visiting contains any malware or if it was involved in a data breach. So for me, it's an excellent way to see if I should even be visiting that website in the first place. So that said, those features are only available in the Firefox browser extension. So if you want to use an app on your device, it'll only block ads, trackers, and malicious links, but won't provide those additional statistics. Then on the subject of blocking ads, CleanWeb did manage to pass the canyoublockit.com test very nicely, but I have noticed a few ad blocking mishaps with static images and Google Analytics ads. Now, if you're also interested in using Surfshark VPN, it's a great VPN provider. It's got reputable security measures and privacy measures, and it's a great option to access geo-blocked content or secure your connection. Okay, to summarize, you can get the best ad blocker for Firefox without spending too much. Yes, free options are not as effective now, but a premium ad blocker is not going to just block ads, notifications, pop-ups, and malicious links, but could potentially provide you with VPN service, anti-malware protection, and more. That's why I recommend that you stick to a trustworthy ad blocker like NordVPN, Threat Protection, or Surfshark CleanWeb. They're easy to try out for free. You can get a lot of value from grabbing any of these Firefox ad block options. But what's your go-to ad blocker for Firefox? Let me know in the comments below. And remember to like and subscribe while you're there. Thanks for watching. See you later.